What's up, y'all? It's your girl Crystal.
And this is the Star.
And this is the YouTube channel. What you know about that?
That's right, where we listen to your favorite hip hop, R&B, gospel, and pop albums from the past that we listen to in the present. Almost forgot the intro. Almost messed it up. Crystal would have been happy. We listen to in the past, present, future, but today we're going to pull up, switch up, rewind, guess up, y'all. It's reaction time.
It's reaction time.
All right, enough.
All right, again, we just reacting to some of, you know, the classic videos from the past or from hip-hop, R&B, even pop. With some live performances, and on this video we are reacting to Q-Tip's Vivrant Thing. I'm ready.
Check it out now. No doubt now. Yeah. Check it out now. No doubt, yo. Special girl, real good girl. Biggest thing in my itty bitty world. Caught her up and she made me feel right. Wish the bliss could never take flight. Sitting back with this mic in my hand. Spitting hot shit, trying to see grand. Imprinted on my mind every minute. Make my plans and you always in it, y'all. Such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. And even though we both fly, give each other space and not the evil eye. Acting like grown-ups, don't even try to hide, cause the spot blown up. Girlfriend telling you she wanna see. I say I don't know, but you say gladly. And when we both do it, we go on and on and on and on and on and sweeter than Ben and Jerry. In the rhyme, well, you know I guess mine. Sitting around in my abstract car. This abstract thing going abstract far, yeah. Such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Yeah, such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Check it, check it,
look at
me. Check it,
look at me.
Yeah, such a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing.
Look at you,
check it,
look at me.
Check it,
look at you,
check it,
look at you, yo, yo.
Yeah, it's such a vibrant thing. Vibrant, Getting back to my MC status, all the willy that I kick make the other niggas maddest. Moving through your town of situation. Shorty thought she subtle, but she really was blatant when she shook a thing and violated. Now these wolf-like thoughts are formulated. I'm saying, oh, is there some heartfelt here? Am I showing back? Well, yeah. Plus we can hold the convo or go to the movies, my crib, whatever, yo. Just wanna see you by my side. We on 95, know the stash is in the ride. Against the real, you would find me in the cypher if I didn't cop a deal. Rap slate like big weight, you buy, I sell, we split big cake. Just move your little thing, move it around and shake a little thing. Yeah, such a vibrant thing, vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Yeah, you're such a vibrant thing, vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Yeah, such a vibrant thing, vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Vibrant thing, a out, yo. Yeah.
Okay, all right, all right. Yo, to me, the highlight of this is the instrumental. That instrumental grabs you. We talked about previously how songs back in the day, they grab your attention immediately as soon as they come on, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And this instrumental, very, 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 simple, But it does its job of like, yeah, like all that instrumental, all I hear is a guitar riff,
right,
and hi-hat.
And it's simple. And it's literally it's simple. It's simple and it's
bass,
slap.
Maybe some bass in
it. Yeah, just little bass, little bass, little that. But it's a very simple. It's very simple of a beat, but and what's also very simple is the fact, not simple as like a diss,
right?
But it's simple like, you know, instruments, like right. actual fucking instruments,
right.
You know, and you don't have a lot of those. You'll have like, you don't have a lot of those right now, and I guess that's, and also that's probably why, a main reason why people look back at the nostalgia that was the 1990s and they're like, no, this was a better time.
Right.
You know, the 90s nostalgia, just everything that we do on here is, the 90s nostalgia is so great, you know, that, and it's a good thing, but it's also a damaging thing.
Why do you say that?
Because it doesn't give a chance for now to actually have like a space or a play, because you hear so much stuff from back then, mm-hmm. and they're bringing it out now, even into like songs. Like you'll hear a sample of Aaliyah, you'll hear mm-hmm. a sample of this song, a sample of that song, mm-hmm. and even though hip hop has its, even though hip hop got its start, hip hop and like. Rap got its start off of samples. Mm-hmm. It doesn't. It kind of demeans the fact that, you know, musically, even with other genres, it can't evolve from the nostalgia of back then.
I think I understand what you're trying to say.
I'm probably wording it really wrong.
Are you trying to say that? Because the 90s was so good and people always kind of want to relive it, it impacts today's music from finding its own identity. Is that what you're trying to say? Okay. I understand that point, but I don't think that that's on 90s R&B or 90s hip hop. It's on the lack of creativity and knowledge of actual music of the actual people who call themselves artists today. Just because this shit is super, super good doesn't mean, well, where do we go from here? Like, the stuff from the 70s and 60s was super, super good. But the difference between producers from the 90s and rappers and R&B artists from the 90s is they studied their craft. You feel what I'm saying? They took time to appreciate chords and like you said, the instruments and things like that.
Right.
Today's artist is just lazy. They're lazy and they just want to sell us something as quick as possible, to where it's not even about the music anymore. It's literally just them being able to sell us a song so that they can make their record company or themselves, you know, right. you know, money. So they're taking out the actual soul and feeling and natural approach that music just has in and of itself. They're stripping it to make it commercialized, and it's a shame. So that's why I always come back to things like this. Q-Tip. Now, I didn't even know Q-Tip was a part of a different group. I thought he was a solo. I think my first time ever hearing about him was through this song. I didn't know he was a part of Tropical Quest or whatever.
Yeah. The Apple Bum, that was.
So to see him like branch out or whatever, he has a very unique voice too. It's like it's almost like nasally, but not too nasally.
Right.
Like if it was too nasally, I would probably get annoyed very, very quick. There's some nasal approach to it, but it's very unique. Like if he comes on the mic, like you would know that it was him. I oftentimes confused him and Mos Def, cause they kind of remind me.
They do sound like, to the untrained ear, like they sound a little bit of the same. Mos Def just is a little.
His voice not that nasal. Mos Def's voice is not that nasal. But then the imaging is remind, like both like natural niggas. They both probably like believe in Islam or whatever. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That's the vibes that I'm giving. 5%ers or something. You know, which is, you know, ain't nothing wrong with that. That's what you believe. Blah blah blah. But this was a banger. I wonder if this ever like charted like back in the day. But this is a
no, I'm laughing at how you say charted.
I mean, you know what I'm saying? Like, I get what you're saying. You know how the billboards are or whatever. This is a very good song. This is a good song. It does that thing. It grabs you. It keeps your attention. You feel me? The video was cool too with him and the girls. You feel me? It was cool. This was cool, smooth shit. Shout out to Q-Tip. You know, I guess I never really listened to Q-Tip, but I think if this was my first introduction as an adult, it would make me want to listen to him a little bit more. So, yeah.
Yeah. This was a good little vibe. You know, this was a good little vibe. Be sure to like, subscribe, leave your love, leave your hate. Support all Black content creators and Black-owned businesses. And tune in to the next episode of What You Know About That.
What you know about that.
What you know about that, because
we know all about that. Bye. Bow, 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 bow. Bow, 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 bow.